Good day to you, viewer. You are welcome to today's Open Level Review. Today is Thursday, 28th of October, year 2021. My prayer is that none of us will die untimely, and God, being tarry, He will make us to see more years. And if He come so soon, or even now, we will end with Him in Jesus' name. Today we want to consider the yoke of Jesus, the yoke of Jesus. But in the meantime, can we pray? Dear Father, we thank you for who you are. We thank you for everything. Thank you for giving us you. And we thank you for the salvation of our soul. Lord, as we go through this, your word this day, speak to our lives and let your words do something good in our destinies. We pray, Father, grace to be identified with you without being put to shame. We receive in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So we'll be considering the book of Luke chapter 14, verse 26 to 27. Luke chapter 14, verse 26 to 27. If any man come to me and hate not his father and mother and wife and children and brethren and sisters, ye and his own life also, he cannot be my disciple. And whosoever doth not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. That is the word of God. So what is God saying here? What is Jesus telling the disciple here? So he said, if any man come after me and do not hate his father and mother and wife and children and brethren and sisters, yea, and his own life also, he cannot be my disciple. You will be wondering, but this same God said we should love. How come he said we should hate? Now the word he tread there is trying to say, you must not love your father, your mother more than the way you love Jesus. That is to say, in your life, Jesus comes first. In everything you want to do, it takes priority. No one, even you, cannot love your life more than you love Jesus. That is, you must be ready to sacrifice everything to follow the course of the Father. That is what that place is simply saying. So you must be ready to sacrifice everything to follow the Father. A story was told of her father in the Lord when he was to go for a crusade and his beloved mother was sick than home. You know what he did? He told the mother, you know, I love you, but I love Jesus more. I have to go after the assignment of the father. Unfortunately, before he came back, the mother got home and she lived many years after. You know what that one is telling you? Sometimes we place what we love to be, to have issue with the father, we place them against the father because we love them more than the father. So Jesus wants us to show that we love him more than anything. So for us to follow the father, these are the price we must pay. We must be able to love him beyond and above everything in our life. So if we don't do that, we cannot be his disciple. So he has mentioned your family, he has mentioned your sister, he has mentioned yourself. So we must love Christ above everything. And whosoever doth not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. That's another thing. Having loved Christ beyond everything, we must be ready to carry our cross. The word cross is not what is sweet. The word cross is not what is enjoyable, so to say. Because looking at the book of Hebrews chapter 12, when the Bible was talking about Jesus and the cross, the Bible says because of the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross. That means cross is not what you enjoy. Cross is what you endure. You know what Christ is trying to tell you? That following me will require you to pay one or two sacrifices. So you carry the cross. It was said in the book of John chapter 16, verse 33. He said that in me you might have peace, but in this world you will have tribulation. That's part of the cross. He was talking in the book of Matthew 11, 28. He said, come unto me that I labor and heavy laden. I'm going to give you rest. He said, for my yoke is light and easy. There is still a yoke of Christ you are to carry, though it is light, though it is easy. He was saying somewhere in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17, 2 Corinthians 4, 17, for our light affliction, they are but for a moment. He was saying in the same scripture, he said, for many are the afflictions of the righteous, a righteous man. He was in the same book of 1 Peter, it was chapter 5, around verse 10, thereabout. He said, having suffered for a while. So there is price to pay when you are to carry your cross, you carry your yoke, and to follow Jesus Christ. Romans chapter 8, verse 18, he said, for the suffering of the present time cannot be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in us. All what this place is trying to tell is that following the Father, require you to carry your yoke, and this yoke are what you must pay as a price. He says somewhere in the scripture too, he said, they that desire to live godly, they will suffer persecution. So whosoever does not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. You can say you are following the Father and you don't carry the cross. So you must carry the cross daily. You carry it daily, excuse me, and you begin to follow Jesus Christ. These are the price that you must pay as a person. And when you pay this price, it requires so many things. It's going to be identified with the Father. You know, let's read our memory verse. Philippians chapter 3, verse 10. Philippians 3, 10. That I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering be made conformable unto his death. This was Paul talking here. You want to know the Father, it takes you following the Father. But when I follow the Father, because I want to know him, I want to know the power of his resurrection, I must be ready to know the fellowship of his suffering as well. So I don't fellowship with the Father within the area that is also, that is good, that is sweet alone. I must fellowship with him to know the suffering that he passed through. So Paul said that we should be glad that we are partaker of the same suffering with Christ Jesus. So be made conformable of his death, be made conformable of his death. So for you to follow Christ, for you to say you want to be a disciple of Christ, you must be ready to carry your yoke. So you must be ready to be identified with Jesus Christ. And being identified with Jesus Christ require you following his standard, require you following the belief of the Lord Jesus, require you to be committed to everything that is of Jesus Christ. So it is until then you can have knowledge of the truth and have the genuine freedom. You know, because we don't have this mindset that there is a yoke to be carried, many believers simply disappointed when they come to Christ. I must tell you, there is a yoke you must bear. For you to submit to the Lord Jesus Christ, you must be ready to face so many things in this world. Some don't even know what is called persecution until they came to Christ. Coming to Christ is not for bread and butter. You have yoke to carry. You have persecution to go through. Maybe I should say at this point, having given your life to Christ for many years, if your door has not been knocked in form of persecution, in form of affliction, in form of one or two things, then you need to check the kind of Christ that you remove, I mean that you receive. Because the day you give your life to Christ, the devil begin to go after you. And my prayer is that it will not get you, in Jesus' name. So many people don't want to identify with Christ today. You know why? Because they don't want to, they don't want to experience some kind of difficulty, some kind of a shame, some kind of, no. I'm too well placed in the society for people to know that I am of Christ. Look at a man called Joseph Arimathea and someone else. And in the scripture, Jesus was condemned as a criminal to death. But this man still went to go and take his body. The one was a worthy man, a man who was rich, and yet he was able to go and request for the body of Jesus Christ. He was identified with Jesus Christ. So the summary of what we are saying today is that you want to follow Christ, ready to carry your yoke. Can I pray for you? The grace to carry your yoke and follow him. The Lord will give unto you in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for your word this day. And we ask for the grace to follow you. We ask for grace to carry our yoke. We ask for grace not to deny you. Please give unto us. Save the unsaved. Bring people to your kingdom. Give us grace, Father, so that we can stand with you at the end of the day. Thank you, dear Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless you. I'll see you next time.